I cannot believe the day has finally come that I get to do a safety inspection on the RX-93 new Gundam. This is just amazing. Like, it's in our hangar bay. The safety manager's gone. He's gone for a day, so I ain't gotta deal with his bullshit. I get to just relax and see the inner workings of this beautiful machine. The fact that Admiral Ray alongside Anaheim Electronics built and designed this in 3 months is pretty astounding, alright? I know they had a whole battle to fight, but it's just amazing. It's amazing what they can do when under pressure. So guys, let's just go ahead and start taking a look, a deep dive into this, and see the inner workings of this beautiful machine, alright? We might find something that is very unique about this particular machine, so let's get into it. Now, something to note before we even get into the machine, guys, it's a weird kind of minty green, and I think that's because of the cycle frame. Whenever it was pushing back the axis, it started illuminating green with all the cycle frame, because obviously in the cockpit, it has like a cycle frame cockpit. So maybe just it got stained with all the Psychomu kind of emanating space magic. I don't know about the weird stuff that goes on with these machines. All I know is, does it meet the safety requirements to push this machine out once again for more skirmishes? But yeah, just ignore all the weird green minty look. All right, so the height of this machine is 23 meters in total. You're gonna have a max weight of 63 metric tons. That's a big hefty boy. It is going to be Gundarium alloy, which is gonna be for the armor. And obviously it is equipped with the Psycho-Frame. And it looks beautiful, obviously. That Psycho-Frame just gives it that nice, beautiful touch. The overall design aesthetic of this, I mean, this is not even about the safety. This is about just pure art, my lads. This is peak Gundam. I don't think there's ever been a Gundam in our history here over at Anaheim Electronics that has been a better machine than this. There hasn't. Simply, they has not been a better Gundam than this. The movement and overall articulation of this machine is immaculate. It can go in every direction that you can think of. So if it is in a, you know, pretty much of a bind that it needs to get moving in a very quick manner, I mean, it has the thruster output to make sure it gets out of a certain situation or get to a certain location in a timely manner. And it can also maneuver its, you know, arms, its legs, so that way it can get into the positions that it needs to win the fights. That's all I can ask for, so I think it meets all those safety requirements. I'm not seeing any kind of issues there. Next thing I'd like to talk about is going to be the weapons. So let's go ahead and move out to the isolated city. Alright, now that we're out here in the isolated city, let's go ahead and just cover some of the weapons. First thing we're going to talk about is going to be the 60mm Vulcan guns on its head. It basically just shoots some rounds out, so if it does lose its weaponry, at least it has some kind of short distance projectile to kind of like hit incoming missiles or just to kind of like distract the opponent. Next is going to have two beam sabers. One is going to be on the back, in which that one actually has a beam that can be pushed out from the bottom of the hilt, but also a big one on the top. And it's going to have another one on the left forearm, so basically you can deploy another hidden beam saber in case it loses the one on the back. Alright, next is going to be the beam rifle. So essentially its main weapon, it just shoots beam projectiles, and that's kind of it. There's nothing really too noteworthy. The beam doesn't like rotate and spin like the amazing Age 1 normal does, because that dodge rifle is a beauty. But this is a little bit before that time, so it's just a more primitive, I would say, beam weaponry system. Next is going to be the new Hyper Bazooka. Honestly, I love the play on words, you know, new and the Greek alphabet new, this name it. Y'all get it. Anyways, new Hyper Bazooka can shoot it honestly on its back. So if it is just kind of sitting stationary on its back, it can still project the ammunition from there. Just, you know, through the sensors from the machine when it clips in. But it can also just hold it on its arm, so if it does want to like carry it and actually shoot it manually, it can do that as well. But you kind of get the best of both worlds. If you have the beam rifle in one hand, you get the beam bazooka in the other on the back. But unfortunately, maybe you lose a little bit of that, the accuracy, since you are maneuvering your entire body to shoot that ammunition, that cartridge, the missile from the bazooka. Next, we're going to have the shield. Looks beautiful, gorgeous. It's going to have a little emblem on the front. But it's not just a defensive shield. It's also a weapon in itself because it is going to have a beam cannon right underneath it, as well as four small missiles that it can go ahead and shoot. So pretty amazing that it is going to have some kind of offensive capabilities alongside the defensive capabilities. And last but not least, probably one of the most peak things in this universe is the funnel system. Honestly, it's just something that's beautiful. You know, having something that's remote that you can actually utilize from the cockpit. I mean, these new types are crazy. They're a crazy bunch. You know, I'm not going to go ahead and get into it with any of them because I don't know if they're going to, you know, start flying some spoons around me in the cafeteria and start, you know, hitting me with that shit. So I kind of keep my guard off them. But in the field, I mean, look, they're doing some miraculous things. All right, and those fin funnels is proof of it. It's going to have six of them. You can equip a twin funnel set. So you basically omit the beam saber on the back, and you can actually deploy three on each side, or if you want to do double fin, you can do six on each side. But I mean, that's pretty goddamn ridiculous in my opinion. But for here, we do have these six fin funnels. They just kind of get on the back, and then you can deploy them from there. They can actually create beam weaponry, or you can actually have a beam shield, like a little pyramid shield. So pretty amazing. You can do all that crazy stuff. Look, it's kind of beyond my pay grade and, you know, my, you know, area of expertise. So let's just go ahead and finish up. I'm gonna wrap it all up in the hangar bay. So I'll meet you guys over there. Let's go. All right, guys, welcome. We're just gonna go ahead and wrap everything up for this. Look, this is the new Gundam. All right, it's flawless. You know, I'm looking through this machine, I'm looking at his weapons, I'm looking at his capabilities, his movements, his speeds, the overall weight, I'm looking at everything. There's not one error in this entire machine. It is perfect. It is entirely perfect. So, I don't know what else to tell you guys. I would say if you have the capabilities, you have the strength, the mentality, you have the clearance to pilot an RX-93 new Gundam, you better take that chance. You better get on that opportunity and you pilot that damn machine, because this is not only a machine to win wars. This is a goddamn work of art. All right. But that's all I got. Larry, you got anything? No? Jim? No? All right. If I got no questions, you know, we've done our little, you know, Eric, we did what we need to do. We've done our little safety checks. This thing's cleared to sortie. I don't have anything else for it. I don't have anything else for y'all. Enjoy your weekend. You know, have fun with the family. Maybe not be in space, you know, this time around. We got Xeon still out there doing some crazy shit. So I'll see y'all on the next safety inspection. All right, guys. See you later.